Hey everybody, Star here. What is going on? Today we are graced by the presence of the first place map from the King of the Hill map contest, a map that completely deserves first place in a contest. Any contest, really. King of the Hill Arctic is a great map. It was brought to us by a man named Hans, also responsible for bringing us the map CP Mojave, which wasn't really that popular of a map, not very well known, but in its own right it did get second place in the contest that it was entered into. And if it means anything, I really enjoyed Mojave when it first came out, I played that all the time. But, Hans, you've outdone yourself now. This is not a second place map, this is a first place map, completely deserving of it, because it's so much fun to play on, it is so well balanced, and it's got snow on the ground, it's not even warm tick yet. Once it goes up to warm tick, it's like very first place, that is beyond first place. Visually, Arctic is not a very complicated map, but for what it is executed very well, and the same goes for the balance of this map. It's not a very complicated map balance-wise, but it plays excellent. There are some things that you could very easily compare Arctic to that already exist within the game. For one, the midpoint right here is much like CP Granary. It's got crates, it's got health packs on top of the crates, and it sort of has a similar placement to where the control point is. And that's not a bad thing because CP Granary has a very fun mid to fight on. And here, the map design is pretty safe, where it takes that and understands CP Granary mid is pretty cool. So let's do something a little bit similar to that. And then overall, the feel of the map is very much like Viaduct. And not just because there's snow on the ground, the health pack placements are very similar, and the paths to the midpoint are very similar to Viaduct. And that's not a bad thing, because Viaduct is also another fantastic map, one of the only King of the Hill maps that actually gets played in 6v6 competitive. So, loosely combining concepts from Granary and Viaduct, maps that both have already proven themselves to be very fun to play on, makes Arctic a map that is just fantastic. It's very well balanced for pretty much anything. I can see it being very successful in 6v6, Highlander, pub play, pretty much anything that you take this map on, it has value. And of course this map has a chance to be improved even more over time, especially now that a lot of people will hopefully be playtesting on it and giving it a try, or at least seeing it here and seeing what they think about it in the first place. I urge the developer, Hans, please continue development on this map. I'm pretty sure that you would anyway. And anyone else who is watching this or has given this map a try, if you have any constructive criticism on Arctic or really any map in this contest, go over to the map thread on tf2maps.net and leave a little bit of feedback to give the developer an idea of what you think about the map, what can be done to improve it, because I'm sure a lot of these maps may be improved over time. A big part of map development is just receiving feedback in the first place, to understand what you need to develop on your map to make it even better, and understand what people that are playing on, what they want to see. And this is definitely a community that we should continue to support. TF2 mapping community over at tf2maps.net is fantastic. We get great maps like this, and we don't even have to pay $15 for it. Anyway, I hope you guys have enjoyed this look at King of the Hill Arctic. If you do have a Team Fortress 2 server that you could put this map on, that would be fantastic. Giving everybody a chance to play this map and making it a little bit more popular. It definitely does deserve it. But until next time, I will catch you all later. Peace out, everybody.
Alert! The control point is being contested.